Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with wgpu graphics programming in Rust. In the last two videos, we discussed the color map model and the simple 3D surface construction. In this video, I will explain how to use this color map model and the functions implemented in the surface-data.rs file to create a 3D sync surface. As shown here, this is a 3D sync surface. Here is the definition of the sync function. It is equal to sine r over r. Here r equal to square root x square plus z square for r not equal to 0. It is equals to 1 for r equals to 0. In fact, the sinc function is a Fourier transformation of the rectangular function. Here, we will use the gate tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this video. Now let's start Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu from here. This is a Visual Studio Code interface. Now let's start a new terminal window and cd into the code folder. From this folder, create a new folder called wgpu15 and cd into it. Now we can clone the source code used in the last video with the command git clone wgpu14. After this command, we leave a space and a period. This will place all our source code in the current folder. Now run this command. Okay, we can check direct. You can see all the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now we can open this folder from Visual Studio Code, open folder, code, wgpu15. Here contains the source code used in the last video. Here we need to add the sinc function to the mass-func.rs file. From src folder, open mass-func.rs file. Here we already have sphere position and torus position, two functions here. Now we need to add a new function here, the sinc function. Here we define the r equals x square plus z square square root. This function takes x and z as input arguments. We then define the y function. If r equals to 0, it equals to 1. Otherwise, is equal to sine r over r. This function returns a pointer array x, y, and z on the sinc surface. Okay, now we can save this file and close it. Next, we need to make some changes to the min.rs file. From src folder, open min.rs file. Here we need to replace its content with the new code. Since most of the code for render pipeline and render path have been already included in the common.rs file, here the min.rs file becomes very simple. You can see here. We first introduce the common and mac func modules. Inside this min function, we define two command line arguments. One is color map name, we set the default to jet. And another one is isToSide. We set it to 1 by default. Next, we create the vertex data by calling createVertices methods defined in the comment.js file. You can see here, vertex data equals comment create vertices. Here we use the mass.func sync function. We just defined it in the mass.sync.js file. And the color map name, we also define the X range and the Z range for our sync surface. And we define nx and z. This is divisions along x and z directions to 30. You can see both nx equal to 30 and nz also equal to 30. We also specify two other parameters. One is scale and one is aspect. You can see we set the scale to 2 and aspect ratio to 0.7. We then call the common light method to generate the light data. Here we use 111 for the specular light color. And we also define ambient light intensity to 0.1 and the diffuse light intensity to 0.8, specular light intensity to 0.4, and the specular saliness to 30. Of course, we introduce this is two side parameter, which is specified by the user from this command line argument here. Next, we call the common run function here with the vertex data created here and light data, as well as the color map name as input arguments for this run function. This run function will create our sync surface. Now we finish the modification to the main.rs file. We can now save this file. Up to now, we have finished all the programming for this example. Now in the terminal window, we can run this application using the cargo run command. This is our sync surface with the default parameters. The default parameter, for example, the color map is jet. You can see our surface has two side lighting. You can see this is front side. This is back side, also has the same lighting. Now let's check what happens if we use one side lighting by setting the isToSide parameter to 0. So we close this window. So we can use run and the color map we specify, for example, SSV, and specify the isToSide to 0. So this means the one side lighting only. So run this command. Now we get this picture. You can see the front face here has the same lighting effect, but the back face here has no diffuse and specular light. It only has a weak ambient light here. We can also change the color map name. For example, we can change it to other color map. Close this window and change it to, for example, change it to cool color map, to cool color map, and use one boss side lighting. To run this command, you can see we changes this sync surface has a cool color map. and both sides, front face and back face, has the same lighting effect. Of course, you can change other color map because we define 11 different color map names. So we can change to other color map. Now we have completed this example. In next video, I will show you how to create a simple 3D peaks surface. Thank you for watching.